Okay, hi Ben, how are you today?
Good.
Today we're going to work on a special kind of word problem. Are you ready to learn how to do change problems? Okay, we have learned before about total problems. That's when you have two parts and you put them together for a total. And then there's difference problems, and that's when you have two things that you're comparing for a difference. Today we're going to learn about change problems. Are you ready? Look at my hands. When you're learning about change problems, you have a start amount, okay? And that changes. It either increases or it decreases to a new amount. Show me that with your hands. You have a start amount and it can increase or it can decrease to a new amount. Awesome job. Okay, now I have a question. Do you know what increase means? What does that mean?
The number goes higher.
Very good. Increase means the number goes higher. It gets bigger. It's more, right? Okay. So do you know what decrease means?
It goes lower.
It goes lower. The number goes down. It becomes less. Awesome job. You are so smart. This is going to be easy, isn't it? Okay. So we're going to look at this word problem. Are you ready? Here it says, Fred had two crayons. Then his friend Sam gave him five more crayons. Now, Fred has seven crayons. Okay, so this is like a change problem, okay? We don't have to solve this problem, but it is a change scenario. So, let's look at this. Fred had two crayons. Then his friend Sam gave him five more crayons. Now, Fred has seven crayons. I'm gonna show you that with my hands. Fred had two crayons, then something happened. Did he get more crayons or less crayons?
More crayons.
More crayons. What happened to give him more crayons?
Increased.
That's right. Sam gave him five more crayons, right? So his amount's going to go up, right? We're going to look at this word problem. He has two crayons. His friend gave him five more crayons. Now he has seven crayons. We're going to write that like this. Two plus five equals seven. That equation tells us what's going on in this problem. He had a start amount of two, then his friend gave him five more, and now he has seven crayons. Let's look at how that works. Here's Fred right here. See his name? That's Fred. How many crayons did Fred start out with?
Two.
I don't have any crayons, so we're going to use these as crayons today, okay? Fred has two crayons. Okay. How many crayons does Sam have?
Five.
Well, we don't really know exactly how many he has, but we know that Sam gave him five more, right? So I'm just going to give him a handful of crayons. Okay, those are Sam's crayons. Okay, so Fred has two crayons, and Sam gave him five more crayons. Can you move five of these over there? One, two, three, four, five. Okay, so this is what happened in our story. Fred had these two, and then he got five more crayons, right? That's the change that happened. I'm going to write that a different way, okay? I'm going to write that like this. Fred had a start amount. How many did he start with?
Two.
He had two crayons. Then something happened. What happened?
Sam gave him five more crayons.
Five more crayons? Yeah, there was a change and it increased what he has. So this is his change. And then his start amount plus he had a change, and that equals his end amount. How many did he end up with?
Seven.
Seven. Seven crayons. Okay, let's look at this another way. Because we don't always have an increase, do we? Sometimes our change can decrease. So let's look at something else here. Let's look at this story problem. This says Harry had nine crayons. Then he gave three crayons to Will. Now Harry has six crayons. Okay. What happened in this story? What's Harry's starting amount?
Nine
crayons. Then something happened. Is there a change?
Yes.
What happened?
He You gave 3 crowns to Will.
He gave 3 crowns to Will. So he started with 9, and then he gave 3 crowns to Will. How many crowns does he have now?
6.
He has 6 crowns. Let's see how that one works. Here's Harry, right here. How many crowns did Harry start with?
9.
Let's put 9 crowns there. Is that 9? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, those are Harry's 9 crayons. Okay. Does it say that Will has any crayons? We don't know. We don't think he has any crayons right now. Okay, so if Harry had 9 crayons and he gave 3 crayons to Will, awesome. Then how many crayons does Harry have left?
6.
6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's right. So we would write that as 9 minus 3 is the same as 6, right? This one had a start amount. Was there something that happened that changed how many he has? Mm-hmm. What happened?
He gave 3 crayons to Will.
He gave 3 crayons to Will. So did his amount increase or did it decrease?
Decreased.
It decreased because he gave it away. Do you know what? When it decreases, we have to say minus the change amount because we're taking some away, right? And that equals our end amount. So our start amount was 6. We took away 3. Our start amount was 9. And we took away 3. And now he has 6. Let's try this one together, okay? Here, let's read this problem. There were 9 apples on the apple tree. Then 5 apples fell off. How many apples are on the tree now? Oh, you know what? We did not run through our problem. We're going to read the problem. There were 9 apples on the apple tree. Then 5 apples fell off. How many apples are on the tree now? Next, we underline the label. What do you think this story problem is about?
Apples falling off a tree.
That's right. So we're going to underline apples because that is our label. Can you underline apples? Right there. Good job. Awesome job. Okay, now we name the problem type. This is a change problem because we have a start amount and there's a change that's happening. Okay. We're going to use these steps right here to solve our change problem. First, we're going to write our change equation. Do we have a start amount?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Then, what happens in this story to change our amount?
5 apples fall off.
Okay. So if we started with 9, and we have a change that 5 apples fell off the tree, are we increasing the amount of apples on the tree or are we decreasing the amount of apples on the tree?
Decreasing.
Why is that decreasing?
Because 5 apples fell off.
Yeah, they didn't grow back on the tree, did they? Okay, so we are going to write the change equation. And you said apples fell off, right? So we're going to write this equation. The start, ST for start, minus C for the change equals our end amount. Awesome! You wrote the change equation. Very good job. Okay, now we're going to look at step 2. It says find the start amount. So now we're going to look for the start amount. Look at you. Is that how many you started with?
Mm-hmm.
Very nice. So let's go ahead and write underneath the ST, we're going to write 9. Very good. Now we're going to find the change amount. How many changed? How did that change?
-5.
-5. Good. And then we're going to find our end amount. How many did he end up with at the end? It doesn't tell us. Do you know what we do when we don't know? We're going to put an X You know why? Because that's the treasure we're looking for. Does X mark the spot? Very nice. Now, I need you to write the signs. Okay? Minus. Very nice. Okay, so now, does this look like something you know how to solve? 9 minus 5 equals what? What is 9 minus 5?
4.
Good. Can you write 4? Okay. Right. X equals 4. Okay. We talked about what our story problem is about. Do you remember what our story is about? You underlined your label. Do you see your label?
9 apples.
It's about the apples. So let's go ahead and write apples. Very nice. Okay. Good job. Okay, so does that answer make sense? Is 9 minus 5 the same as 4?
Mm-hmm.
Good. And were we asking about apples? How many apples are on the tree now?
4.
4 apples. Very nice. Okay. Let's do another.